Welcome again. Today we'll talk about how to create any Power Automate flow using Microsoft Teams. In previous video, I've already covered how we can perform Power Automate integrations with Teams and do several actions like administrator. Here we'll discuss how we can create any automations through Teams itself. So whenever you open any of your workflows Teams account, just click on this and from here you'll get an options to create. Here, whenever you'll proceed it further for creating any automations, you will get an options to either create from blank, which will give you editor where you will select actions which is available similar like Power Automate Cloud version. Now, to build any automations, I wanted to trigger manual trigger a flow. Here, I will add next step where I need some emails to be connected. So here I will use Outlook, Office 365, and either I will send an email. In this scenario, I'm selecting an email and that email to be triggered on my personal account. So here I will use Rai. Okay, this was the email I wanted to send it out on my personal email ID, and here this is a subject. Automation email. I don't want to add anybody, but still I will copy and paste some data here. And in advanced options, if you want, you can attach any attachments and keep it to reply to all. That's the options I wanted to perform it here. Let me save it, and once it is done, I will run this process or run this flow and we'll see the result as well. Because I wanted to trigger this as manually, I will click perform Office integrations. It's already signed in, then I will proceed it further, and this is tested now. Next process, I want to run this process and see here my automations is successfully triggered. Now, next process is to let's check our email. Did we receive the email or not? Say this. So exactly same email which I received from Microsoft Teams automations. Now the interesting factor here, we have built automations in Teams and the same Teams automation will be also available on Microsoft Cloud, because Cloud, Microsoft Power Automate Cloud, Teams, Microsoft Office are well integrated with each other. So these type of automations are very successful when we are using for any enterprise into any department. See, you can see this. So exactly the same automation is also available. Whichever actions we want, we can perform it. It is very easier and quicker. Once we have the integration in place, I mean Microsoft Power Automate integrations with Teams, we can quickly build any flow and run it. For that, we don't need to log in into Microsoft Cloud. I mean, Power Automate Cloud, we can directly trigger this automation through Teams itself, which is very quick and responsive. So it was a very easier and small process which we have built so far. But if you want, we can also create or use some templates like this. Here we have three logins required: Microsoft Forms, Planner, and Microsoft Teams. Whenever we'll use these templates, I have to sign in because I've already integrated with these platforms, added credentials. That's the reason it was showing green. Otherwise, it will ask your credentials. Once you'll click on next, this template will start using it. Simply, if I wanted to save a message to Notepad or OneNote, we can also use this flow. Exactly similar way, we also have forward emails to channels, which we can also do that because Teams is well integrated with this platform, and Office 365 is also provide the permissions, but if you want, you can add new credentials. Now let me build this and show you the result. So flow name I wanted to give here for emails to a channel. Let me get it, set up your flow. This is my Power Automate group, and under this I wanted to send any emails to this chat. It will create the flow, and whenever I will trigger, so whatever emails I'll receive, it will send out on chat window. Now this flow is ready to use. Let's go to the home. Execution has been started. It will check out for emails and send out whichever new messages are received on Outlook or on my email ID. Normally this is not taking that much time, but here maybe because of the email messenger or messenger, we are expecting the delay. But whenever our automations will trigger, we'll have that email messages forwarded into this chat box in this channel. So that's how we can build any automation flow through Teams and trigger the processes from Microsoft Teams as well. And that same automations will be available on cloud version. And if you can see the history of the executions, I mean, let me go back, responding a bit slower, but now as of now, there's no execution found because we have interrupted the process twice. So that's how we can create any automations flow within Teams for Microsoft Power Automate. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you wanted to learn more about Power Automate, you can feel free to refer our channel where I have already created more than 70 video related to Power Automate, which will give you a detailed insight about the Power Automate learning. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content and support the channels on giving your like and subscribe and adding the comments into the comment box. That's all for today. Thank you for watching.